Another one bites the quickie. The first federal gun control act was the National Firearms Act of 1934. The Supreme Court case upholding it was 1939's United States v. Miller. Jack Miller and Frank Layton were charged with unlawfully transporting a double-barreled 12-gauge shotgun with a barrel less than 18 inches from Oklahoma to Arkansas. The colloquial term is a sawed-off shotgun, although really, it was manufactured that way. The district court actually agreed with the defendants that this is a blatant violation of the Second Amendment, but the government appealed to the Supreme Court. Somehow, they got to jump over the appeals court. At the Supreme Court, the government argued that this wasn't anything to do with infringing on firearm ownership. It was just about collecting taxes, and since it went across state lines, they were just regulating interstate commerce. Yeah, right. But the rest of their argument is telling. They said the Second Amendment only protects military-style rifles, since it's there to make sure the citizens can form an organized militia. Do you see? They then said they could ban any non-military-style rifles, and now they're saying they get to ban military-style rifles. Is there any way the dishonesty and duplicity of gun control proponents can be more obvious? Well, yes, actually, because of the final part of their argument. Since sawed-off shotguns were never used by any military, government could ban them. Even though that wasn't true then and isn't true now, lots of militaries have used short-barreled shotguns. By the way, Miller didn't get to show up to the proceedings because he'd been murdered. What it was really about was racism. Hardly surprising since gun control is a eugenics policy. In this case, there were a couple of cases of Italian Americans using short-barreled shotguns to commit holdups. And since it was associated with those horrible Italians, well, we just gotta ban it. And based on all of that, Congress was able to pass the National Firearms Act, the real intention of which was to ban all short-barreled guns, including handguns. It was based on Michigan legislation, which basically said there's no point in banning handguns unless you also ban short-barreled rifles and shotguns. And who lobbied for that legislation? The KKK. They wanted to stop black people from having concealed firearms. You can guess why. One of the congressmen behind the push for the ban was Hartzell Reagan, who said, "I am unequivocally opposed to pistols in any connection whatever. If you want something in the home for defense, there is the shotgun and the rifle. But a pistol is primarily for the purpose of killing somebody." Recognize the rhetoric? By the way, Reagan was later the judge in the Miller case, having been appointed by FDR. He knew that Miller wouldn't be able to show up for the Supreme Court case because he just testified against his entire gang, and so he'd either be dead or in hiding. He also knew that the Supreme Court was mostly FDR's people. But the silver lining in all this is that the Supreme Court did confirm that military-style weapons are protected by the Second Amendment. In fact, that's the whole point. Citizens, for their own protection and the protection of society at large, should have access to the same weapons that governments do.